So we have now reached the stage where we've actually chosen the architect and team that is going to build a new campus. This is a $134 million build-out, the first purpose-built University of Art and Design in Canadian history, I might add, because most universities of art and design in Canada and most of the United States are generally built in old facilities, such as Central St. Martin's, which was built over in St. Pancras train station. Most of the time, it's repurposing. In this case, it's actually purpose-built. And for those of us that have been involved in thinking that through and working with it, one of the promises that I can make to you all tonight is that if you come to the opening, and I hope you will in 2017, you will see something unlike anything that you will ever see anywhere else. A university that is designed to be transparent and open and permeable to the community of which it's a part. A university that stands for 21st century learning, which by the way is not 20th century learning. This is a new generation of students, a new generation of thinkers and makers and creators. And these are students that desire a different place, a space, a way of working. And what we figured out, and I think we've been successful at doing it, is how to make them happy in the process of doing it. Although, I must say, to counter that, that I'm very happy when they have a good old existential crisis. So, we're involved in the development of something that I think says a great deal about Emily Carr, the painter. Now, we haven't talked about Wu. Do you know who Wu is?
Yes.
So, some of us know who Wu is, and Wu is, of course, the monkey that sat on her shoulder day after day, sometimes month after month. She was a very eclectic woman, she was a very innovative woman, and she was very much in the avant-garde of her time. And what we are trying to do as a university is reflect that kind of beautiful eclecticism and at the same time reflect at a deeper level how learning and learning in the arts, which is about making and creating and thinking and producing, how that is actually fundamental to the future of our culture and our society. It's a great challenge today because education is perceived to be a direct kind of process that produces a direct kind of outcome. And I'm fond of saying, if I had gone to university knowing exactly what I was going to be when I graduated from it, I wouldn't be in the job I was in today. I would warrant that most of you actually went through the same experience. I doubt that most of you have actually been trained to be what you are. And if you have, good on you. But if you haven't, I think you know what I'm talking about. We're trying to keep universities open. We're trying to keep them adjusting to and sensitive to the nuances and changes in our culture. And in the car, we're trying to build that culture. So the other thing that's significant is that we're 90 next year. 90 years in Canada is like 500 years in England. And 90 years in Vancouver is like 1,000 years in England. Because Vancouver is a young city. And to be 90 in Vancouver and to have survived over that period of time is a significant, significant achievement for the institution. I should also say, and I think that Sarah would perhaps correct me, that Emily Carr had a relationship with what was then called the Vancouver School of Decorative Arts. And her relationship with the institution was actually a rather up and down one. She both disliked the notion that kids would be taught, you gotta be a creator, forget about learning how to be a creator, it's gotta come from the heart, from the body. At the same time, she was fascinated by the fact that mostly it was women who were taking these courses and trying to become the artists of the future. And from that tradition, of which she was a participant, and I might add some members of the group seven were also participants, this school has produced some of the best and most famous artists in the country. I won't name them, but as I'm fond of saying that back east, because we're out west, back east, they look lovingly and sort of longingly at what's happening in Vancouver, because Vancouver's produced many of the greatest artists in Canadian history over the last 50 years. Why? A mixture of things, a mixture of the Pacific Northwest, a mixture of the whole environment in which we operate, tremendous insecurity, which produces more tension, attention, and intention. So I want to express to you all a tremendous thanks. I'm really absolutely in love with John Walton Bennett. I'd like to get him to give another speech. He speaks so well, and I appreciate from all of you, and thank you all for taking the time, the energy, to come out here. It is significant for a small institution to be named in this way. It'll mark our history forever. I can assure you that we will mark it forever. Thank you very, very much.